Hello guys, and welcome to a new video series of Let's Playing. We're going to be playing Call of Juarez, Gunslinger. I know it's spelled Juarez because someone who actually knows Spanish corrected me on this. I actually used to call it Call of Juarez, and actually it's Juarez, or Whores, as we jokingly said. So this game is the fourth game in the franchise for Call of Juarez, and it's set in Western time, so there are no Mexicans, so it's a bit weird why they call it Call of Juarez. They could have maybe set it as its own game, but I guess they wanted to rack in the sales, so they decided to use the franchise as a selling point, I guess. They've had three games in the past before this. They had the first one, Call of Juarez, then they had the Bound in Blood, which was my best one thus far. My opinion might change depending on if this game is any better. And they had a terrible one called The Cartel, which was set in modern time and which received very bad reviews and wasn't really good at all. But I haven't really played that because of the terrible reviews I've heard and from the people who have played it, so I kind of left that one out. So all in all, my opinion of the franchise is pretty good. Hopefully this one can live up to it, but from what I've read, it seems okay. So it's set in a Western era, there's no Mexicans. You play as a bounty hunter called Silas Greaves, and in this era you're going to be coming across and fighting lots of famous people in the era from the real life. So you'll have people like Jesse James, Billy the Kid, Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid, and you'll be coming across them, fighting them and whatnot, so that'll be good. And I think we'll move on now, looking at the video options. This is a downloadable title, so I don't think it's retail. It's going to be on Xbox Live, the PlayStation Network and PC. And I'm playing this on a PC right now. And this game is priced at a sort of small game, I'm assuming. It doesn't have multiplayer, it's all single player. And I'm guessing that, considering the price, it costs $14.99. In the UK, so I'm guessing the amount of hours it might take might be around 6 to 7 hours to complete the game, maybe less, but we'll see how it goes. I mean, I'm not really gonna spoil it anymore, and we'll look into the video quality now and see what kind of video options they have. So you can see that the amount of options you get, they're not too bad. Everything I expect from a good PC port. We'll see how it plays first, in terms of shooting and using the mouse. You can also use your Xbox controller if you have one. It's compatible for that use. But here you can see texture quality, shadow quality, foliage and view distance is far, which is something not many games put in, I've realized. It's always set to a certain distance, so that's good. And you can either choose to filter through the different kind of performances, your best performance, balance, the best quality. But I mean, for this we'll keep it on as best quality. And I mean, apart from that, it looks good. Let's get on with it, and I hope you guys enjoy. Okay, we're gonna be going for story mode, and we'll go for normal. Hope you enjoy this.
Easy, boy.
Don't I know you, sir?
Don't believe so. I haven't been here in many years. Name's Silas Greaves.
Silas Greaves? The bounty hunter?
Used to be.
What are you doing here in Abilene?
Just passing through. Got a little business to take care of.
Well, sir, it would be an honor if you would allow me to buy you a beer.
Hell, son, it would be my honor to drink it.
I'm Molly. Howdy.
I'm Dwight. That's Jack and Steve. Ben's behind the bar. Oh, I bet you got some great stories.
A couple.
Any of them true?
Jack, be nice.
A few.
What about your shootout with Henry Plummer's gang in Bannock, Montana? Is that where you started as a bounty hunter? That's what it says in this here dime novel.
Don't believe everything you read in them dime novels, boy. First man I hunted was back when I was riding with Billy the Kid.
You knew Billy the Kid?
Damn right. That scrawny son of a bitch had no fear. Wouldn't back down for nobody.
I heard he collected the tin stars off any crooked lawman who crossed
him. It was a war, boy. The Lincoln County War. And Billy promised his regulators would take the life of every bastard who helped bushwhack John Tunstall.
Kid had a big chip on his shoulder and a hair-trigger temper. Made him dangerous as hell.
That was the introduction. So, this game premises is Silas Greaves is actually telling a story. And there are a few interesting turns in this game. Something you'll come across during when he tells a story. So this'll be fun.
It was about 30 years ago. Billy was hiding out in an abandoned farm near Stinking Springs.
Well,
I threw in with the kid because the man I had sworn vengeance on was riding with Billy's enemies. But before I tell you why I want that sumbitch dead, let me tell you what happened that day. I was heading back to the hideout when suddenly I had this funny feeling.
Funny, haha?
No, Steve. The other kind of funny.
Well, it looks very cartoony, sort of like Borderlands 2-ish. Press zero? Uh-oh. Return to the hideout.
Stay here and keep an eye on the road.
That's not fair. We're missing all the fun.
I knew those two morons would never let me through. I had no choice.
Nope, we're not gonna crouch through this. It looks very cartoony.
Who's that?
It's you, Russ!
You need it for leveling okay, you can earn experience by killing enemies, and you need it for leveling up and gaining extra abilities. Press space to continue.
Was it Pat Garrett's posse?
Oh yeah. I heard the shots and I knew I had to move fast. Garrett and his army of deputies had surrounded the entire homestead.
Spread out, goddammit!
They're coming from the rear!
I decided to help Billy and the boys out of it. So that's just what I did.
Well, I assume that's all I'm dead.
Hey, we have one behind us!
Stay on it! Covering fire!
As the governor of New Mexico was paying for the kid's apprehension, Garrett was able to hire every gun hand in Lincoln County.
Alright, time to reload. Right, there's another one here somewhere. I don't see anyone else.
I knew that going through that front door meant putting my butt in a shooting gallery. So I decided to get sneaky.
Wow, what's this? Take secret? You've just leveled up, press U to open a skills menu. You have one skill point to spend here now, selecting the free skills category and purchase its leftmost skill. Dual wielding desperado. Hell yeah. Okay. And that was that. Now I have two.
Watch out! He's one of them!
God damn it!
These men were running around like a bunch of chickens with their heads.
Whoa!
Still, one of them reached the water tower.
Holy crap, that was amazing.
Would be a turkey shoot from up there.
Come on, reload.
Kill him!
Alright, where are the rest? The style is a bit weird. It clashes with
luckily these shooters Garrett
the characters
sharpest tools in the shed.
I've got this.
A lot of them were saddle tramps or sod busters or drunken drifters looking to make a few bucks.
Ooh, right in the head. Right, okay. Let's move on.
I heard a friendly voice yelling at me from the window.
Back door! We got
we'll
you
cover you!
Try aiming, you idiot!
Watch your
truth
brain.
Be told, things weren't much better behind the house. I cut their numbers in half. But that just made the ones that were left twice as mad.
You can kill me too?
Sure is a lot of reloading.
They made up for their lack of skill with a seemingly endless supply of ammo. It was a bit of a slog, but I finally fought my way around the back of the house.
Okay, there seems to be some sort of jerkiness, and it's not the frames, it's just the way the character moves, unfortunately, which is very weird. It's really weird. It's smooth in some areas, but in other areas it just starts jerking. Seems like there's some issues with the camera or its optimization.
Like that, I was inside, dead, you bastards. None the worse for wear.
Oh wait, he's on my side.
Dirty Dave.
Dirty Dave.
Upstairs I found Billy and Charlie Boldrick.
Okay, where is Billy?
How about that? Huh? You like that?
That must be him.
Billy looked at me and said, "About time, amigo. Grab a gun and get to the window."
Wait, so you were friends with Billy the Kid?
Yeah, sort of. Anyway, we were surrounded by dozens of deputized shooters who wanted to do us harm.
Dead or alive.
I'm telling you, Garrett's men were dropping like flies, but they just kept on coming.
Well, time for a big explosion. Oh, I have to reload. That was very crap.
That's when Charlie got hit. Catching us in a crossfire, shouted Billy. Get to the other side.
Well, 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 come on.
I personally put down, but it was pretty clear, even to Billy, that maybe discretion was the better part of valor.
What's that mean?
It means that it was time to cut and run.
They got a Gatlin, Billy shouted. Get the horses and bring them around back. I'll draw their attention.
Well, I don't see anyone else. No, I'm guessing we're going. Hello. Ow. Stay
directed
there.
That order at me, and I thought, why the hell do I have to do? But I went anyway. Dumbass that I was back then.
Those poor sons of bitches are done for.
But I had that false sense of invincibility that many young men like Jack.
What are you saying, old man?
Jack is just joshing with you.
Yeah, he better be.
Mr. Greaves, please continue.
Please, call me Silas, ma'am.
Well, I don't know what the hell that was that.
You were heading for
holy
the
crap.
Making my way past a passel of fallen foes.
That was amazing. Because we can. Hello.
Regiment of hired guns.
Yeah, and just when I thought I was done with them, more of these hapless bastards would pop up. Finally, I had the stables within my reach.
I wouldn't say that's within your reach yet.
And that's when I met Sheriff Pat Garrett.
I read that you went toe-to-toe with him, sir. That backstabbing bastard with that tacked-on tin star.
Proud, handsome, and ham-handed. Pat Garrett. Mexican standoff?
You challenged him to a showdown.
You read that in a dime novel?
It said he showed no fear as he took your measure with eyes like a rattlesnake.
Okay, now what? Ah, you bastard.
And that you killed him. In a fair fight.
Is that what that Penny Dreadful said? No, boy. That ain't what I meant when I said I met Pat Garrett. So let me start again. I finally reached those damn stables.
You bastards.
Stepped inside, and... last thing I heard was Garrett's voice. That's not Billy.
And go on, how did it end?
End? Boy, that was just the beginning.
That's what I said when I meant this game has a bit of a twist. Now, you saw this mission where Silas was actually talking to the people at the bar, and sometimes he might make things up, and he'll get caught out on it, so the game will actually go back and he'll try to recollect what he said and try to correct the story. So you will actually have to replay some parts, and sometimes he might get the wrong, he might say something wrong, and then he's like, oh right, this is what happened, and then he'll actually retell that part of the story again. And while he's retelling it, you also have to replay that, but it's going to be a bit different, like what happened just now. And I think that's a really cool thing that they've added.